Hello everybody, I am Vivek Kumar, District Governor Nominee of Rotary International, District 3250. It represents the states of Bihar and Jharkhand. You see, to begin with, the biggest feat of Rotary till date is the total eradication of polio globally. When we started the polio eradication campaign in the year 1985, there were nearly 3,50,000 cases of polio every year. But today, I am very proud to say that we are having only near to 100 cases of polio per year around the globe. We have been able to make India totally polio free. In countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan, we are working relentlessly with the government authorities to end the reservoirs, which are the last of polio virus, and thus make India totally polio free. And the world totally polio-free. Due to this, we have been able to bring smiles to millions of mothers and children. Now, let me tell you how we work. Before I tell you about the welfare schemes which have been undertaken by us, our impact in the community begins with our members who work tirelessly to solve some of the toughest community challenges. Their efforts are supported by the member association Rotary International and Rotary Foundation. The Rotary Foundation turns the donations into grants and funds the projects being undertaken by the members and their partners in service. Thereby, you will see that we are working in a very scientific way. Our members are responsible leaders, and they work through their clubs in which they are representing the areas, and they are focusing basically on the local and social issues of relevant nature for the local people, which are, I would say, that they are the local problems. To name some of our few welfare schemes which have been undertaken by us. Firstly, I have already spoken about the polio program, and we have been successful about it. In Bihar, we have started with the breastfeeding, the awareness for the breastfeeding. And this is a major cause of concern both for the urban society and the rural society. So we are focusing on both of them. We are creating awareness through skits, presentations, leaflets, pamphlets, one-to-one interaction with small communities, small gatherings in the rural areas, getting hold of the mukhyas, and we are making them aware of the breastfeeding. The second area of focus is that we have built about more than 10,000 toilets till date in Bihar, in the unrepresented areas where the sanitation conditions were very bad. Though the Bihar government has also undertaken it, but yet we are also doing it. Even the Prime Minister is focusing on it. And apart from that, a real innovative thing which has been done by one of our Rotarians in Muzaffarpur, she is Dr. Vijaya, that she has innovated and developed a sanitary napkin. And it is being made by the cooperative workers who are female workers of our society itself. And we are providing the adolescent girls sanitary napkins free of cost. And we are creating awareness with them about the hygienic use of the napkin and the safe disposal of it at the same time. Number two, three things I have spoken about. And fourth, we are already having the polio centers, immunization centers at many places. Nearly, I think, 97 centers we are having in Bihar. Now, since we have been able to eradicate polio totally free, we are focusing on the total immunization program. Right from the conceivement of a child till a child attains 1 year of age. We are providing the total immunization free of cost to the mother and the child to be born and after he is born till his first year. The biggest achievement after polio, and I would say that buoyed with the success of polio and making India and totally the world nearly 99% polio free, we have Rotary has adopted Rotary India Literacy Mission. The Rotary South Asia has adopted the Rotary Literacy Mission, and in India it is named as Rotary India Literacy Mission. And in Rotary India Literacy Mission, we are aiming at a total literate India in the next 5 years through our TEACH program. I would like to tell you that T stands for teacher support, E stands for e-learning, C stands for child support, and H stands for happy school. These five letters represent five projects, though they are all interlinked with each other. So we have focused on these five projects. Teacher support, talking about the teacher support, we are providing volunteers to schools which are not represented properly by learned teachers or teachers who are able to provide basic education to a child. You see, our aim is not to make people educated. Our aim through this program is to make them literate. This is the basic thing. We have provided more than 1,000 e-learning kits to different schools. Through e-learning kits, this program will be facilitated in a more smoother manner. Talking about child support, I would say it's a very new thing, and a very successfully we have been able to work in remote areas in North, if I talk about the Kosi region, if I talk about North, the remote areas of North Bihar, South Bihar, we have been able to work and implement it very successfully. A child who is going to a school, most of the children in the rural areas who are going to school, their parents are illiterate. What we have done is that we have made that child a teacher. And the child is a teacher to his parent. The child is making his mother learn how to write and how to read. For this, we have designed and customized special innovative books and literatures, which have been provided to children. We are having a team of experts who are working 24/7 on it. And they have been able to implement it very successfully. And I am very proud to say that more than 400, I would say, parents are today literate. They have learned how to read and write. In the last 4 months, 3.5 months, I would say, precisely, they have been able to read and write. Talking about happy schools, what is happening to the government schools? They are in a dilapidated condition. What we are doing is that we are in the remotest rural areas, or even in slum areas, if we talk about the capital town of Patna, there is a slum locality called Adalat Ganj. It's very nearby. It is located in a very posh area, just behind the income tax building, Central Revenue Building. And you can imagine the area which is, but there is a, it's a slum locality. They are having a school building. So by happy school, what we mean that the happy school is having a covered shed properly, first of all. Number two, it is painted properly. By painting, it does not imply that only once it will be painted. We will maintain the painting and cleanliness throughout the years to come. We are providing safe drinking water over there. We are providing one hygienic toilet with the maintenance. And we are providing benches, proper benches to sit. Because basically, these there were few buildings, they were having floor sittings. Now we are providing them benches and free books from the primary classes. This is the TEACH program. One more program which I have forgotten to talk about is the WINS program, which has been launched by Rotary. It is the wash in schools. The children are not aware about the hygiene. The hygiene of the importance of washing the hands. Even if they go to a toilet or even if they go for a loo or whatever it is, they are not washing their hands, they are not cleaning their hand, and thereby it is having an adverse effect on their health. And most of the malnutrition or the food poisoning cases you have is due to the unsafe drinking water and the hands which are not, I would say, clean, due to which they are having problem. So we have launched this Wash in Schools program, and we have about 50,000 soaps will be distributed in different, the schools are being identified, the areas are being identified by our experts, by our volunteers, and we will be visiting that school, those schools, and we will be providing them soaps free of cost for 3 to 4 months, teaching children how to wash their hands.